You probably clicked on this video because you want to optimize your FlutterFlow app for speed and performance. Many people have apps that have many actions, and this can slow down the app, which is not good for the user, and it's not good for search engine rankings. The good news is that there is an easy fix for this, and that is what this tutorial is going to be about. So let's get straight into it.
Now, that is search engine optimization. What about optimizing for performance for your application in general? Well, the thing is, when you're creating this, you're not really worrying about the code or viewing the code or making sure that you don't have to worry about that. You're building it visually, right? But when you're also thinking about perhaps if you're doing something custom and you're having custom code here, you want to make sure that structure, not only will FlutterFlow help you to make sure that you're not going to have any errors, but just think about when you're using this, what kind of other things to factor in, what's the functionality that you're doing? For example, if you're using actions and you're in the action editor, you're doing like 50 actions, what's going to happen, right? What's the speed, all those things. So those are things to consider. And then also too, if you're doing a lot of advanced functionality, are you using something more perhaps to help the speed of the application? What do I mean by that? Well, if you're going to be using something like Rowy.io, or if you use something like BuildShip, you might be having a low-code backend do a lot of the heavy lifting. For example, this allows you to basically put this on top of your database. But now if you're doing a lot of queries or you're doing a lot of high-level calculations where you're using another programming language to do your calculations, this can help you. That's one way. Rowy is one way to do that. The other one is if you're looking at BuildShip. Now, this allows you, if you're doing a lot of API calls or connecting to a lot of things, and it's a lot of computation, some people decide to use BuildShip on top of using it with FlutterFlow. So this will help with optimizing for performance. You're actually having this do a lot of the heavy lifting, then it's integrated into FlutterFlow. The question comes back down to is what kind of application you're creating, why are you creating it, and then what do you need to have, what kind of functionality, or what are you looking to do? All these things are great factors to consider, because when you're looking at speed and performance, you always want to make sure that your speed or your application works as fast as possible and people are having a great experience. But based on what you're putting on the application, it might slow down. So all of these factors to consider: how you're saving the information, what custom code you're using, what other supplemental platforms you might use like Rowy or BuildShip will help you in your determination and to optimize performance of the code. But also, like I mentioned, if you're trying to rank higher and people to find your application, looking at the SEO component as well.
That was a short clip from the complete FlutterFlow developer course inside the No Code MBA membership area. Now, to get full access to this course and many other No Code tutorials, simply go to nocode.mba or click the link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like and share this video and subscribe for more tutorials like this.